Hello everybody, welcome to How to Do RC. I want to thank you all for watching to a new episode of the Unbreakable $5 trainer plane and how to make a polyhedral wing out of cardboard that is just almost as unbreakable as the body. We do of course going to cheat and gonna use a wooden doll for 120 centimeters long, and then we're gonna cheat by using extra long winglets at the sides at a high angle. And I made three sections of 40 centimeter long cardboard, and so as you know, 15 centimeters and 16 centimeters. Then I already did the pre-bending so we can make the airfoil. And I made three sections of this, so 3 times 40 centimeters makes 120 centimeters. And I'm gonna be using a wooden dowel for 1 meter 20 long that is square and is 9mm by 9mm. Just check the grains to make sure that it doesn't flex ups and down as minimal as possible. In the previous video I did show you how to make this whole wing just using wood glue, but that cost a lot of time. So to save me on some time, I'm gonna be using my hot glue. And just press it down and keep it down there. And just do everything in three sections so your glue doesn't harden out while you're preparing the wing for the wooden dowel. And we're gonna make some front inserts from foam with an airfoil shape so it makes easier for the cotton to fold over it and to get a nice perfect airfoil shape. I'm cheating a little bit, I know, but I just got the foam, it makes it easier and faster and lighter of course than having to use cotton as a filler. But you can of course, you can of course. The next step is actually folding the wing over and gluing it together, but it's smart to glue the three pieces that we have with some wood glue now that you still are able to get there. And now it's time to glue the wing and make that nice airfoil at the front edge, so let's start. And then using a roller to put some extra pressure on it while it's drying. Make sure that everything is lined up at the nice rear edge, that everything is perfectly aligned. And you get a nice airfoil that is 50 centimeters wide. And then as last step, the rear leading edge just glued together and fold down with your roller and make sure you put enough pressure and remove the excessive glue that you don't need. Now that we have completed building the wing, it's time to tape it. The only downside is it takes just as much, if not even more time than just building the wing itself. I also always like to work taping from the back and then layer for layer to the front edge so that the wind cannot get under the tape. Now that the wing is ready and taped in, now it's time to mark the center of the wing so we can line it up with the body and making sure everything is in perfect alignment with each other. Now we have built the wing, we have taped the wing, we have marked the center of the wing at the underside of the wing. Now it's time to go and cheat and make this into a polyhedral wing by adding very large winglets, but not straight up. We're gonna glue them on an angle, a very sharp angle of like 60 degrees, and they are about, and the dimensions of the big winglets are 50 centimeters at the bottom, they're 50 centimeters high, and they're 10 centimeters at the top, so there's an angle of a cutoff from 5 centimeters. The winglet is taped in and completely waterproofed. It's always remarkable to see how quick things go on YouTube. Now you only need two postcards to make reinforcements for the winglets. Keep them on a high angle, so we're gonna bend them right in the middle, 45 degrees. Don't break them, just bend them. Make sure they are on a high angle. Put the postcards around the middle of the airfoil and then just tape it down sideways from top to bottom. And now a couple of times vertically around the whole wing. When that's done, add one layer of tape at the underside of your winglet and place that with the line up with the wing. Nice, perfectly dead on. And now we're going to tape the postcard to the winglet. Pull that up nice and tight and make it nice and smooth and aerodynamic. Now we only have to reinforce that joint by adding a couple of layers of tape all around the winglet, and just do double layers to make it really strong and stiff so it will hold for a long time. And finally, the polyhedral wing is finished. Now using just one wooden spar, it means it's really stiff and it's not gonna break during flight. And it's just gonna be as strong as the body itself. And that's gonna be the next episode where we're going to mount the wing to the body and add all the pieces of the puzzle together and finding the CG, the balance point, and then setting everything correct to make it turn and fly. I really hope you like this episode. If you're new to this channel, I hope you subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss the new upcoming episode where we're going to build the plane and test fly it. And thank you all for watching, and I really hope to see you next time. Goodbye.